Ladies and gentlemen, we're certainly glad to be here tonight. Speak for yourself, Jerky. That's Jared.
Every dummy to his own taste.
Now, cut that out.
All right, let go of the suit. I'm getting out of here.
Now, wait a minute now, Willie. Just stay right here. Mm-hmm. I mean it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry if I said anything. I didn't mean it.
Oh, no?
No.
No?
No.
Just tell me this, wise guy. You did admit that you were superstitious now, didn't you?
Well, on occasion, yes.
But you don't throw salt over your shoulders or cross your fingers or anything like that.
No, I knock on wood.
Well, you did it again!
Wait a minute. No, wait a minute.
I resign. From now on, I'm a single. As for you, you can turn in your lap.
Why, Willie, in the first place, what would you do without me?
Well, for one thing, I could be a better ventriloquist.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Watch this. A funny thing happened to me on my way over to the club tonight.
Is that a fact? What happened, Blockhead?
I was out in front of the Ritz Savoy. And that's where I live. Out in front of the Ritz Savoy.
You put formaldehyde in those jokes? Oh, something must deserve them.
You're watching a ventriloquist named Jerry Etherson, a voice thrower par excellence. His alter ego sitting atop his lap is a brass stick of kindling with the sobriquet Willie. In a moment, Mr. Etherson and his knotty pine partner will be booked into one of the out-of-the-way bistros, that small, dark, intimate place known as the Twilight Zone.